It seems paleo gurus don't talk for long before they bring up celiac disease and gluten intolerance. For those who legitimately suffer from those issues, avoiding gluten is not optional. However, for the rest of us, to argue against eating gluten because of the problems these people have seems to me to be an example of an exception fallacy. After all, celiac disease is known to be a genetic disorder. The usual idea to explain this is the timing of the introduction of grains to past cultures, so that the descendants of those who adopted grains more recently are more prone to celiac. However, celiac seems instead to be the result of a positive selection based on the immune system. As we have seen, as cultures adopted agriculture and came to eat grains, they lived closer together, and their immune responses adapted. Examination of our past Homo ancestors reveals that genes related to celiac disease may have provided an advantage in resisting epidemics that would have struck dense populations. The genetic traits for celiac may have persisted as a balancing polymorphism due to a heterozygote advantage, with the homozygote much more likely to develop celiac disease. A classic example of a balancing polymorphism is sickle cell anemia, which also has immune advantages in its heterozygote form in protecting against malaria. The case that celiac has been positively selected for immunity continues to build. On the other hand, the hypothesis that the evolutionary novelty of grains caused celiac doesn't seem to have gained much traction. The paleo people also blame grains for schizophrenia. Lauren Cordain wants you to think that as well. However, this recent review of environmental factors in schizophrenia finds a lot better candidates to consider than grains. There does seem to be a link between schizophrenia and celiac disease. But don't forget, celiac is a genetic disorder. And this disorder is associated with a variety of neurological symptoms. 35% of the celiac sufferers in this study had a history of psychiatric illness. So we shouldn't be surprised that celiac and schizophrenia share genetic variants. To ignore all this just to scare people away from grains, implying that they will cause mental disorders, is highly irresponsible in my view. What about gluten intolerance? Gliadin is a glycoprotein that is increasingly getting the attention of paleo promoters. However, I noticed that the references offered to support this concern here were all in vitro, meaning in isolated lab tests and not in patients' bodies. In this test of subjects without celiac disease, no anti-gliadin antibodies were detected. Certainly, gluten intolerance in non-celiac individuals seems to exist. However, it isn't clear how many people it affects. It certainly seems to be a minority. Alessio Fasano is a celiac researcher Lauren Cordain cites to support his fad diet. Let's see what Dr. Fasano himself has said about diet without Cordain filtering his ideas. He asserts here that past humans only ate meats occasionally. In response to claims that gluten sensitivity is widespread, Dr. Fasano said, "I have a really hard time believing that we are plagued by this." He characterized gluten avoidance in the general population as only a reflection of a current fashion trend. Authorities on celiac disease say that adopting a gluten-free diet unnecessarily is always a bad idea. A gluten-free diet may reduce the beneficial bacteria in your digestive tract. Even if you do have celiac disease, you don't need to give up on whole grains. Before I leave grains, let me state the obvious. There is a huge difference between refined grains and whole grains. Cordain knows the difference, but he wants to condemn all grain products. Most people who think carbs are fattening seem to only understand the term carb to mean a refined grain product. You will get no argument from me that refined carbs are bad for you. Not only can the milling of grains remove its health-promoting nutrients, it can reduce them to tiny particles that cause a greater glycemic response. Consume grains in their whole form, with less or no milling, and you may find them to be more helpful in achieving your goals. Responsible researchers who are concerned about the effects of junky carbs also encourage you to eat good carbs, like oatmeal and legumes. That brings us to the humble bean, next in the Primitive Nutrition series.